Under this scenario, the hard Brexit, our estimates suggest that after 10 years, GDP would be lower by around 3%, and the number of people employed would be 40,000 fewer. This is all compared to a no-Brexit benchmark. The estimate is also in, that I've just given you is in line with the ESRI and Department of Finance estimates. These aggregate figures mask the fact that certain sectors and indeed regions of the economy would be disproportionately affected, and some small and medium-sized firms are likely to be more among the hardest hit by Brexit.
I suppose Ireland is in the unfortunate situation, and ye especially, in terms of suffering from a post-banking crisis stress disorder. So unlike other European member states, having gone through a banking crisis and regulatory issues around it, always the human reaction is to over-regulate, right? And that would have happened, and that was due to lack of oversight and regulations and all issues that you're well aware of. Now, as a result of that, we would be seen to be now more cautious than anybody else. Now, the first question I have is, how many applications have you rejected, or have you rejected any? My concern is that companies won't even bother applying and saying, well, look, Ireland, you know, no, they're far too regulated now at this moment in time. So that would give us an indication. But then when people don't apply, we don't know how we're doing. Compared to other countries, is there an analysis of how many applications are done by financial services companies in Britain to other European countries? And do they do multiple applications? Will they hedge, as they would in any other financial situation, and they say, well, we'll apply in Ireland, and we'll apply in Frankfurt, and we'll apply in Luxembourg. And then the critical question really is, and this is towards Mark Cassidy, is since the task force was established, and more especially since Brexit, what reforms have we done to make? I know your job isn't to attract companies, your job isn't to go out and find them, but what reforms has the central bank done to say, okay, how can we make ourselves more attractive? That's the only thing you can do that's within your gift. Have you changed anything yourselves in the central bank since Brexit? Any regulations to say, in order for us to be more attractive?
I think the first thing from our perspective to say is that we're very conscious of the potential for companies to move to Ireland as a result of Brexit. But as we've outlined in our opening statement, we do not have a role in relation to the attraction of business. And that has been explicitly removed from our mandate in terms of that promotional role because it felt that it...
Because of the financial crisis, the central bank's rules were changed so that you're not advocating, you know, you're not out there championing the cause of Ireland being a location, and that has changed your remit. How many other central banks in the EU have the same standard?
Compromised our authorisation and supervisory stance.
The same rule, that they're no longer advocates, they're just saying we're processing the application, that's it. Because that goes back to my earlier question to Mr. Cassidy, is that something that is making us uncompetitive? Because if Luxembourg Central Bank are out there championing Luxembourg, and we're not, that's a rule we better change. Because if we don't change it, that's why we're going to lose out.
To answer your question directly, I don't know to the extent in terms of comparability across other central banks that are responsible for regulation, whether that forms part of their mandate or otherwise. I'm not sure.
But just on a competitive point of view, and maybe Mr. Cassidy would answer that question, like in the task force looking at that as an issue, that is a fundamental issue for Ireland. If other central banks are not only being regulatory bodies, but also actually actively engaging on behalf of their country, we are not going to be able to attract them. That's going to be, and we'll be looking at this in 2 years' time going, I wonder why we didn't get those guys. Because Luxembourg were championing their banks, Germany were championing their financial services sector, and the Netherlands was championing theirs, but ours was not allowed. And that's not your fault. But that's the rule that's in place at the moment, and that's one of those regulations that I'm talking about that needs to be changed.
I suppose with all of the authorities that are linked to the same European standards, there shouldn't be any loosening of standards simply just to attract industries.
But I'm not saying we've changed our standards because of that's the financial crisis, post-traumatic stress disorder I'm talking about. We changed ours because the central bank were out there looking for business. And that's a hangover now from the financial crisis that is now going to affect our performance. I would suggest maybe the task force maybe could answer the question when they were looking at the opportunities from Brexit, was this one of the things that they looked at and said, look, lads, here are the rules in relation to other centres. I'm not talking about the standards. I'm talking about the basic rule that central banks in other jurisdictions are out championing, or are they? We don't know. And if we don't know, we need to find out. They're out championing their causes for their financial service sector, and we're not allowed to do it for ours. If that's the case, we A, need to find it out, and B, we need to change our rules.
Just add that, I mean, in terms of promoting Ireland as a location, I mean, we already have in Ireland very effective organisations like the IDA
that are actually
covered by that.
But are other central banks able to champion? Because you're now stopped from, you were doing it previously, yeah. So obviously EU regulations allow for it. So are other central banks doing it?
We don't know that, but I mean, basically it's very important to realise that particularly in banking, you have the single supervisory mechanism. So there's essentially a harmonised and fully harmonised approach to banking supervision across Europe. So an individual competent authority in another country cannot offer a better regulatory deal than they will get in Ireland. So it's very important to recognise this is part of the European-wide framework. So in banking, it's very strong. You have a single institution. But even for the other sectors of finance, you have, say, for insurance, funds, and so forth, there is a sort of common set of standards that are applied. So the scope for other countries to do things on regulatory side is, I mean, what I would say to you, I mean, you're making a very interesting point. There are other dimensions that countries can exploit. For example, some countries are talking about having lower tax rates for British bankers, which actually come to their jurisdictions. That's not a supervisory matter. That's a sort of governmental matter. And a range of other things are being done, for example, changing the language in which forms are put and so forth, which make it more attractive to the UK. But a lot of these are outside the realm of supervision and, of the supervisory authority. There's the government action. But I don't think it's fair to say that Ireland is not being promoted. Ireland is being promoted.
Yeah, I know, but there's a fundamental difference. This,
I think, yeah, but I don't want to dwell on this too much.
We're looking for solutions to problems. I think this comes back to the task force. What has been highlighted here is we have changed our rules ourselves in relation to the central bank promoting Ireland as a location for financial services. If that doesn't change, and obviously other European countries haven't changed that as an issue, we need to find out, A, who they are, and B, are we going to change it? If we're not, we are really at nothing in trying to attract other. Because I agree with you, yes, we have other state agencies who are out there championing the cause. But if other central banks in Luxembourg and other places are championing their financial service centre, and you're not allowed to, then you need to go to government and say, the reason we're not going to get them is because we're hamstrung. And if that doesn't change, we'll be back in 2 years' time going, I wonder why we didn't get those. Thank you, Chair.
I suppose maybe...
Are you planning to do it? Thank you, Chair.
there's a well-functioning and well-regulated financial system.